Good morning, everybody, or good afternoon, wherever you are. It's Thursday, the 28th. This month is already disappearing on us. It seems like it was just New Year's, and here we are just plowing into the new year. I had some plans to do today on some music and had to instead take the boys at the crack of dawn to the vet. Had nothing to do with their neutering. They both have mild ear infections. I think it could have been because of the collars that they had to wear during this period. It might have aggravated, but they've got some yeast issues and a little bacterial stuff. So they irrigated their ears, and I've got medications for them. And Marcello has a little bit of like a eczema on his chin, so I've got some stuff for that. It's like, but all of a sudden my morning turned into about 4 hours worth of dealing at the vets. And you know, with COVID now, we can't go in see a doctor or anything. You have to tell them kind of what to look for, and then you wait in the parking lot. You can't go inside. It's just insane. So it was nice last night. I just sat for a while and just played songs, ran a bunch of songs from Phil's show. And it's so much fun to play those tunes. Whether or not I'll ever get to play them again, I have no idea, but it won't stop me from sitting here and enjoying them and playing them myself. And but as somebody mentioned, it's been mentioned a number of times, though, asking about Jimmy Webb. I did a few albums with Jimmy. He's a remarkable songwriter. I mean, I've taken, like I said yesterday, copious notes. I mean, he was very, you know, renowned for writing Up, Up and Away. By the time I get to Phoenix, Wichita Lineman, MacArthur Park, Galveston. I mean, all these great songs. And Linda Ronstadt absolutely loves Jimmy. And so when we would do Linda's albums, she would always include Jimmy Webb songs on them. And then when we would do his stuff, a lot of times Linda would join in on his albums. But we did an album in 1982 called Angel Heart. And Fred Mullen and Matthew McCauley produced it. It was just, it's a lot of great songs and just great musicians. And I was looking at the lineup on this. And on most of the tracks, it's myself and Jeff Picaro playing drums, David Page playing either piano or electric piano, and then Jimmy would play either piano or electric piano. They would trade back off on that. And it would be Dean Parks, Steve Lukather, Fred Tackett. I mean, the players involved were just amazing. And on different songs, they had background vocals with Graham Nash and Leah Kunkel and Stephen Bishop, Kenny Loggins, Michael McDonald, Valerie Carter. I mean, really a remarkable lineup. Jerry Beckley of America. And the thing that's fun for me is I look at all these people, and I've worked with every single one of these people, done albums with them, and been involved with them. So it's pretty cool when I listen to this. I've got a whole bunch of songs here, but I'll go through. I think I'll start with Angel Heart. But, you know, a couple of years ago, every year except this past year because of the pandemic, we do this gig at the Library of Congress called We Write the Songs. And it's an evening dedicated to ASCAP, the music publishing company. Paul Williams is the president of ASCAP, and so he hosts the evening at the Library of Congress. They have a beautiful, beautiful theater, and it's mostly it's a lot of the politicians, a lot of senators and stuff, attending this in Washington, and it's really ASCAP trying to protect writers. So they're always trying to get legislation to go through. And so what happens on this evening is there's usually maybe about six or so artists who come to this, and it's been a huge variety from from Lyle Lovett to Hart. I mean, just all kinds of different artists, and they try to break it up in the evenings and have all kinds. And they'll talk about the songwriting process. And then I'm part of the house band that the great Chris Caswell is our MD for that. And in the past years, Omar Hakim has been playing drums on it, and myself. Sometimes Dean Parks will come back on it. We have wonderful background singers. But there's a few seats that get juggled around. But one of the years, a few years back, Jimmy Webb was one of the people that came in. And I remember him just sitting at the piano doing a sound check and doing a version of Wichita Lineman that was so breathtaking. I recorded it. It's not very good quality, but I watch it every once in a while and go, Jesus, this guy's like ridiculously good. So I just thought at this point I would just do a little honoring the great Jimmy Webb. And he's, yeah, look him up, you know, and check all this stuff out. It's really something to hear it in full fidelity. I mean, I'm sitting here with this little phone and a Bose speaker, but I just, it's nice if somebody isn't familiar with Jimmy, just to turn you on to stuff. But it's him singing, and with all, on this one, this is the title track, Angel Heart, on it. And this is the one that Fred Mullen and Matthew McCauley and Jerry Beckley from America are singing background on it. And it's me and Jeff Picaro and Fred Tackett and Steve Lukather, David Page and Jimmy Webb playing keys, and then the great Victor Feldman, who was an amazing, amazing musician, massive keyboard player, but he's playing percussion on this. So I'm going to go ahead and play Angel Heart for you. I promise you, I will be playing soon. It's just today with the vet and everything, it's today just got completely out of control. So I'm going to go ahead and go for it. Let's see what we got. A little tonic water here.
Baby, I believe I'm gonna try. Oh, angel heart.
American Bandstand. See everybody. Nice retro feel to that. The dogs are out here on the lawn. I'm listening to this, but I'm looking at them, and they're really frisky now. They've come back. They've had their treatments. They've had breakfast now. They pooped, they peed, and now they are wrestling and running around the yard. They're just such characters. Oh, God. Yeah, I just love them to death. Now they're sacked out. Because we're supposed to get this big, huge, monstrous storms starting to come in, supposedly today. Hard to tell right now because it's still pretty clear out. I mean, there's clouds, but nothing that looks threatening. But apparently, Central California has been just hammered, and it's all on its way down here. So I'm gonna let them enjoy as much time as they can out there because they'll probably be in the house a lot for the next couple of days. Let's see what else we got here. There's some other songs here that I grabbed. See what this one is called here. In Cars. Let me see what this one is. This one is with he and it's me and Jeff and Paige and Jimmy Webb, and Stephen Bishop is singing with him on this one. So let's see what we got. In Cars. So pure Beach Boys in there. It's really cool. Let your baby know in cars, restaurant mobile, two behind the wheel, like double neck guitars. In a car, we fell in love in cars. In a car, probably Dean on guitar. I didn't see guitar credit for this one. He's on every other track. Thank you. It's so got so much Beach Boys in there. It's really cool. I mean, those kind of harmonies are really fabulous, and they're so definitive of that. One of the cool things working on these projects is I did several albums with Fred Mullen and Matthew McCauley. Matthew, beyond being a really fine producer and a great hang, was also an Egyptologist, and he'd been to Egypt and studied the Sphinx and the pyramids, and he had such amazing stories to tell, because that stuff fascinates me to no end. I eat that stuff up like crazy. So it was really cool hanging with him just hearing him tell stories about these things. Another song or two. Let's see what this is. This is called One of the Few. And this is me and Jeff and Dean and Luke and Paige and Jimmy. And it's Leah Kunkel, Russ's wife, first wife, mother of Nathaniel Kunkel, the great engineer, and sister of Mama Cass, and Michael McDonald on this one. So this is One of the Few. Let's take a listen to this one. This is just my little DJ moment here. Here we go. Such a fine pianist, too.
Nothing much I can say. I guess we all pass this way. You know about man, his own jailer, selfish and so unkind, trapped in his frightened mind.
Jeff lays his back piece. Just right back. God, I miss him.
Don't become your kind.
a lot of adult chords in his writing. He's not one of those guys you jam with because he can go so many directions in his playing. So you really got to know what you're doing with Jimmy. It's really great. I'll do one more song here. This is called Work for a Dollar. Let me see if I've got this one in here. Here it is, right here. So I'm going to go ahead and play this one. This one, background vocals on this are Kenny Loggins and Valerie Carter. I remember, it's so sad Valerie's no longer with us. She was so wonderful. The first time I worked with Valerie, she was in a band called Howdy Moon, and I did their album. And she was just such a precious person. Yeah, we lost her. It was really tough. But this is me and Jeff Picaro and Dean Parks and David Page and Jimmy Webb, Matthew McCauley playing synth on it, and Fred Mullen playing percussion on it. So this is Work for a Dollar, and then you can discover the rest on your own. Ooh, tension. Almost like paperback writer. Wow. I haven't heard this since we cut it.
Mama must have loved her book of John. She read it every day. Every time I see a Sandy Land farm, I can still hear Mama say. I still hear Mama say. You gotta. Seen it all before.
labels hated long fades. All of those tracks would have been cut with Frankenstein bass. It was always my go-to instrument during this period, and that was 1982. So that was, we built in around 73-4, so it was on everything. There's so many more great songs on this album, Angel Heart, Jimmy Webb. Kind of some of it reminds me of when I worked with Sean Phillips. I'll visit Sean, too. Sean's an amazing artist, writer, and musician. I'll get to Sean also. He's something special. So I'm going to get running here. I'm just looking out, and the dogs are being funny little boys out there. So I'm going to go out there and spend a little time with them since they had their morning at the doctor. And later on, I'll probably hunker down if it starts raining and do some more playing. And then I'll get down to actually doing some real playing again. But it felt good last night just to take some time and just sit here and crank up the headphones and just rock. It's so frustrating not being out there working. It's weird. First time in 50 plus years that I haven't been out on the road. And it's surreal. But I'm going to stay healthy here. That's it. So take good care. Have a great Thursday, and for all those in the clubhouse, the next live stream will be this coming Tuesday. It seems like we just did it, and we're back again. I better think of something interesting to say, or I'll just read all how interesting you all are, and I'll just kind of join in and watch all of you. But it'll be Tuesday, 3 p.m. Pacific time. Again, my heart and soul is with all the people out there working every day, trying to do good for us. I've got some real close people right now that are in the hospital, and it's really scary. So I appreciate the care they're giving and the caregivers that are giving it to them. So best wishes to everybody. You take good care, and I'll see you tomorrow. Okay, bye-bye.